So welcome back, guys. As you can see, after a long time, you can see this background. So we stopped making these videos because you guys don't like such kind of videos. You only like vlogs, which you rarely see. So today we are going to make an educational video. So we have been lately receiving a lot of questions regarding CSUSB, and people have a lot of questions in their mind regarding the university, the coursework, the fee structure, and the living expenses. So we decided that we will make a video because Ali himself and me, we are busy since it's our last semester and we don't have that much of time to answer each and every questions. And literally there are a lot of people, at least 2-3 every day, asking us about the campus and about the university. So we just decided to make a video. So we'll just try to answer all the basic questions and all the questions that every aspirant has. So we'll start with the questions. So I'm gonna ask him some questions so he can answer his the questions are based on his experience. Yes, we do have similar experiences because we take the same course. We both are MSIST. We are not CS students, but we know information about CS, so we'll be able to help you guys with some CS questions as well, but just basic and in general, not too much in depth.
So if it's related to any graduate, if it's related to fees about CSUSB, we'll be able to answer that because it's fall coming right now and a lot of people are getting admits into CSUSB, and hence we were getting a lot of questions. So what we will do here is Shiv will ask me some questions that he received from, you know, some students or some aspirants that messaged him, and I'll ask some questions to Shiv, that some questions that I received, so that way we can, you know, answer the questions that, you know, ultimately everyone has.
So let's start. The first question is, how is the coursework and university quality in terms of education? And this question is for a person who's asking for MS in CS.
MS in CS. So see, exactly like we said, we won't be able to completely answer that because we do not have the same professors or the same lecturers that we have for MSIST and CS. But what I can tell is the quality of education is much better. But the thing is, I think we just went for one semester at the school.
Yeah, one semester.
And after that, everything for us became online. And what happens in online is that quality of education, you won't receive that quality of education because unforeseen circumstances happened, COVID happened. As soon as we came here, the next semester, COVID happened. So we did not get to enjoy the whole school life or, you know, interact with the professors as much as we could. But yes, the quality is good, but for CS in specific, we will not be able to answer that.
Yeah. And the second question, what is the job perspective in and around San Bernardino? So this question is generic to all the branches, whether it is CS or MSIST. So
yeah, so job perspective in terms of, let's say, internship, right? In and around San Bernardino, you won't get a lot of internship opportunities per se. Let's say if it's related to MSIST or CS student, in which you would be a developer as CS, or in MSIST you would be a data analyst or database admin or whatever. It's not really inside San Bernardino, but most of the internships that people are getting right now, it's work from home. I don't know if, but Shiv got an internship as well. He's currently doing an internship as a data analyst, and it's again work from home. So yes, in that way, you would be able to get internship. It completely depends upon your capability, your caliber, if you're able to get an internship. For jobs, after you graduate, as you all know, COVID is going on and it's really hard for you to get a job. But that said, people are still getting jobs. It's not like no one is getting jobs. People are still getting jobs. So that isn't a major problem. But what I will say is, very honestly, the school does matter. What school, according to me, what school you go to does matter. So you have to take that into perspective.
So one more thing I would like to add. So San Bernardino is situated in such a location that Los Angeles, San Diego, Riverside, Irvine, all these big cities are nearby. So
yeah,
it's within 1 hour to 2 hours traveling distance. So yes, you get a lot of job opportunities. You have heard of LA, you have heard of San Diego. These places have a lot of ID companies and they are big players. So it's easy to, I would not say it's easy, but there are a lot of jobs available in these big cities. So if you want to search jobs, so San Bernardino might or might not be the place for you to get a job, but yes, the cities around San Bernardino are too big, and you know, those are IT hubs. So you will definitely find jobs over there. If you have this, if you have got the skills and calibers to get the job, no one can stop you from getting a job. It all depends on how hard you work and how much jobs you apply, because you know, you are international students here. So for international students, you know the struggle here. So even before coming from India, you should know that you have to struggle a lot here for getting a job, and you have to put in the amount of hard work. So that's basically it.
Yeah, so the question that I keep getting a lot, Shiv, and I would like you to answer that question, is two questions specifically. Is the city safe? That's a question that I keep getting a lot. People keep asking me if the city is safe. Because if you actually go on online and see San Bernardino is safe, it keeps showing up as San Bernardino is one of the highest crime rates and all of that. Is the city safe? And the second question is, how is the environment and how is the community here?
Okay. So first thing, no city or no place is safe in the world. If you are roaming outside like in 12 midnight or 1 or 2 in the night, if you're roaming to places where you're not supposed to go, or you're, you know, just strolling around in the city in night, so it's always unsafe. You never know what happens. No one can guarantee if a city is safe or not.
Exactly.
Even you can be in the safest city and something can happen to you, right? So it's not that San Bernardino is not safe. San Bernardino is safe if you stay within your limits and you stick to your thing. You are a student here and you came here to study and not roam around in the night around the city. It's okay to have fun sometimes, but you have to respect the time and you have to respect some places where you're not supposed to go, right?
Yeah.
So yes, we have been living here for almost 18 months now, 18-19 months now, and God forbid, we all are safe here. We just stick to our things. Earlier, we used to go to school, we used to come back, we used to do our homework, just roam somewhere on the weekends, but during the daytime we never went somewhere out in like late night or something. So for us it was a good experience, and the place we live is just nearby the university. University is like 2 minutes,
yeah,
2 minutes by bus or car, and 15 minutes walking. So the area around the university is pretty safe, and people mostly prefer to stay off campus around the university. And what was the second question?
How is the community? And so that you've spoken about staying off campus, you can also answer that question of off campus opportunities, of staying off campus, how much is the price and all of that.
Okay, so for us, our personal experience, our personal belief is that on campus is expensive. We come from middle class families, so for us, we have taken education loan. And for us, it's very expensive to stay on campus. So we prefer staying off campus because it's relatively cheap and you can manage your own expenses. So if you stay on campus, you'll have to pay for the meals there and you'll have to pay for the housing there. It's quite expensive. Trust us, it's quite expensive.
It's expensive.
The amount of money we spend here for 10 months is equal to the money we spend there in 3 months or 4 months.
True.
So you can imagine the cost if you stay on campus. So the community here, the Indian community here, they're mostly prefer to stay off campus. Yeah.
And what would you say about the Indian community? Are they good? Are they bad? Because people keep asking me, how is the Indian community? Is it good? Do people help each other and all of that?
Yes, I would say yes. The Indian community here is really good. People here help each other a lot. You know that when you are out of the country, you don't believe in any caste. You don't believe about any discriminations. Here, you are together as Indians and you tend to help each other. Take example of our house. He is Muslim, I'm Hindu. There's two people there, one is Christian. So people of all community live in this house, no discrimination at all. We live together as a family, we eat together as a family, we stay here as a family. If something happens or someone is in need for something, we all, you know, rush and we stay together. So the Indian community here is pretty good. We help each other and we are very closely bonded with each other. And one thing is that there are less number of Indians here because Indians here don't know about this university. as you know that less number of Indians, the less of the competition. So it's good here.
Okay, so last question, the most important question is people ask, is it good that we come to this university? Would you recommend this university?
Okay, two factors. If you are tight on budget, you don't want to spend more than 35 lakhs on education, this is the perfect university for you. For MS in CS, I would say yes, because CS has a very good reputation here, MS in CS. For MSIST, yes, but you'll have to put that extra amount of hard work if you want to get jobs in MSIST. Because IST is the field where you need work experience. So if you have work experience, yes, you'll have a little bit less struggle to getting a job. And if you are a fresher, you'll have to put hard work. You'll have to show that you have got that skills and that talent to get a job here. And second thing is, if you don't have any other options, you want to come to US and you want to enjoy the student life or the American life, then yes, this is good for you. Overall, the university is very good. It has average tuition fees. I won't say it's too much expensive, but it's good. So the total budget would be around 35 lakhs, including the living expenses for 2 years, whether it may be MS in CS or whether it may be MSIST. So 35 lakhs would be a good budget if you want to come here.
I mean, I would say keep in mind 35 to 42 or 41 lakhs, because you keep for 35 lakhs in your mind and then it comes out to be 37 lakhs,
yeah.
And you're like, oh damn, I do not have 2 lakhs extra. Don't do that. Keep 35 lakhs, but keep 5 lakhs extra just to be, you know, on the safer side. I would say have 35 lakhs. And yes, recommending the university, it is a good university. It's not bad. It's not a bad university. But if you have other better options, and if you're fine with, you know, taking a loan of that, let's say you have a university in New York, right? New York is an expensive city. California is expensive, but New York is more expensive. So if you're fine with paying that, I would say go for that. But if you have a tight budget, and if you are thinking of going to a good university as well with that budget, CSUSB is a good place to go to.
Yeah. So I have also received a couple of questions. I would like you to answer it. So the question I received most frequently is that what are the chances of getting on-campus employment here? Is it tough? And do people here, the Indian students here, have on-campus jobs?
I mean, see, it's again completely on your networking skills, your communication skills. And I mean, see, it comes down to your caliber, but if you have good networking skills, good communication skills, you are gonna get that job. Because even before our classes started, even before we knew who our professors were, this guy had a job. He had a job at the university even before one day, right? That's amazing. I have so many friends here, I've never heard anyone getting that. Like on day one, not even day one, it was on our orientation day, he already had a job. He went and spoke to a lecturer. He had the communication, he networked, you know, he spoke to her, and it went on and he got a job. I did not have a job until the first quarter. I got my job in the second quarter. Yes, I got it in the second quarter. So it comes down to, even if you do not know how to do it, that is not a problem, because you can learn it over time. But networking and communication skill, if you don't do that here, you won't progress. Communication and networking, you have to keep doing that. It's not hard for you to get an on-campus job then. Graduate student assistant, research assistant, it can be anything, teaching assistant. You will be able to get that, but networking and communication is something that you have to keep, you know, going after.
Yeah, and I have a couple of more questions. How is the coursework and professors teaching? So they want to ask, are the professors helpful? How is their teaching?
I mean, the professors are helpful. No doubt, I would give a 10 on 10. If the professors are helpful on that question, I would give a 10 on 10. Any professor you meet here, they are really helpful. Professor here, they will help you. No matter what, you ask them questions, you email them. Some professors even give you their phone number. Right? You talk to them, they will help you no matter what. The teaching skill set, some professors here are mind-blowing. Like, amazing, amazing. They are on that level. They're really good. But it also depends upon how much are you giving from yourself. Are you willing to learn? If you're willing to learn, you will be able to understand stuff. But if you're just here thinking everything will go by, and at the end of the, like how we used to do in our bachelor's back in India, throughout the semester we would just have fun, and at the end, you know, 2 days prior to the exam we would sit and study. I wouldn't recommend that, because this is graduate, you know, you're doing your master's after all. So I would say you don't have to, you know, studying, you don't have to completely do that, but focus on what you're here for, and I think that should be, you know, quite enough. Teaching is good here.
The next question. So a lot of people have been asking this thing. What is the cost of living here? So our monthly cost of living, staying off campus?
See, it totally depends again, right? Because even though we, like, let's say, we can tell our experience and our rent. The way I got this place is a story again, that's a different thing. But what I'm saying is, it totally depends upon the way you want to live. If you want to live a minimal, you know, expenditure, $500 including your rent and your food should be enough.
Yeah.
It totally depends how you want to live. But like, let's say us, we spend about $600 a month.
$600, $650, depending upon
yeah.
what we eat.
Yeah, what we eat, the rent stays the same. I mean, it. Now see, this room, if you haven't seen what the room looks like, you can go watch the video, the house tour video. But we share this room, so the expense becomes half. But if you want the whole room to yourself, you can do that. Then that expense becomes, you know, the full amount you're going to pay for that. Then it's going to be expensive. But if you want to, you know, split the money, and, you know, if you want to cut down on expenses, I think $500 should be
yeah.
more than enough if you want to stay off campus. We, our experiences is we spend about $600 to $650 a month, because we want to eat a lot of stuff. We go out, we want to eat outside from restaurant and all of that. That's why it's around $600 to $650. But if you want to live a minimal, you know, you're going to cook food by yourself in your house, so that $500 should be more than
yeah.
enough, right?
So $400 for the rent. So this is an example, $400 for rent and $100 for groceries. $100 for groceries for a month is a lot of money.
It's more than enough.
In $100, you can eat 3 times a day for the entire month. $100 for groceries is a lot. Trust me.
Yeah.
If you want to eat burgers, if you want to eat fast food, if you want to go outside, you know, you want to spend money, then yes, your expenses will increase. But I would suggest, if you are tired of money, then just cook your food in the house. That is the safest and the best food that you can get here.
Very
and
true.
Your expenses will also reduce. So even if you're earning, say, $700 a month with a 10 hours job, you'll save around $200 or you'll save between $100 to $150 every month if
mm-hmm.
you cook in the house and you, you know, don't spend outside. So yes, the monthly expenses would be around $500 to $600.
True, depending upon, you know, how you want to spend that.
So I think this is pretty much it, right?
Yeah, I think
if you have more questions,
these are the basic questions that we got, and on top of our head, the questions that we could think about. Any university that you go to, it doesn't have to be CSUSB,
yeah.
right? It can be anywhere in California or in the US, I would say. These are some, you know, simple questions that a lot of us got these questions. I mean, a lot of people ask these questions to us, and on top of our head, these are the questions that we could think of. And if you guys think that we missed out on some, you know, questions and you want us to answer that, you can comment and let us know. We would be, you know, glad to answer that.
Or if possible, you can just ask the questions in the comment section and we'll just reply to the comments.
Yeah, that would be the best thing that can happen.
But I think we have covered all the basic questions that usually
True.
People ask us. So I think this should suffice your questions. And it's time for us to take a leave now.
We will see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye.